my gosh! Look at that!
Ooh, it smells a little spicy.
What's up, everyone? I'm Chris. We've got Steph behind the camera, and we're hungry to travel. We are here in Georgetown, Penang, a major gastronomical city in Southeast Asia that's known for its street food. There's so many unique foods and dishes in the city to try, and we're so excited to get going to try them all, so come on.
Look at this! It's like an ice cream cone. We're on Kimberley Street this morning to try Char Koi Kak, which is a wok fried rice cake. Now we were talking with a gentleman here and he was saying that his stall, his cart, has been here for 60 years. His mom used to run it. He runs it now and they cook it in the traditional way using a wood fire. So you can't get any more traditional than that. And I love this cone that they serve it in. Look at that. Look at all. We've got the rice cake. We got a duck egg cracked into it to add some extra richness. We've got bean sprouts, green onions. They had little bits of the fried lard too. So this looks so good. Get a nice bite of everything there. Mmm, that's so rich. The dark soy sauce, mmm, such a nice flavor. Ooh, it's got quite a kick to it as well from just a little bit of chili he put in. It's quite spicy. The rice cake, it's really nice. It's really soft, actually, and this is more just rice cake as opposed to the radish cake, so there's a more higher percentage of the rice within it. Mmm. Really nice. It's soft. It's not too chewy or anything like that. It just kind of breaks apart in your mouth, but it's so flavorful. And you can really taste the wok pie in it as well because it got just the smokiness from the fire there. This is a very different breakfast, but amazing. Mm. Oh, that's so good. And the little pieces of fried lard in there as well. Mm. Really add something to it. Delicious. Look at all those ingredients in there. It is just packed. Oh, wow. One portion of the Char Koi Kak with a chicken egg is 5 ringgit. It's an extra ringgit for a duck egg, but honestly, we think it makes such a difference to add that creaminess and richness to it. This is honestly perfect way to start our day. Mm. So good.
Yeah.
This is really delicious. Yeah, thank you.
Never tried before?
No, no, first time. I'm really glad we came here.
Thank you.
I really am glad we came here. This is so good.
Look at this pork drying into jerky in the sun in this back alleyway. So cool. That's when you know it's a hot day. I feel like this jerky. We're heading now to a place that serves dim sum, but we have our eyes set on one special thing. This dim sum restaurant's really cool actually. You just come to the back here and it's self-serve. You pick whatever you want, they put it on your card, and you just bring it back to your table on a tray. So it's a really, really cool atmosphere and kind of fun thing to do. So cute. Here we have our special buns that we came here for. The Lao Sa Bao, or salted egg custard bun. Look at the color of these. Just the color themselves would make you want to get one. They're so, oh look at that, so jiggly and soft and squishy. Got a little bottom here, so let's get that off. I think these are gonna have a special little something inside. Hence the jiggliness. Oh my gosh, look at that. Mm. So there you have the egg custard on the inside. Oh my gosh, look at it just oozing out. Oh my goodness. So velvety and creamy. Just look at that oozing out of it. Oh my gosh. It's definitely a little bit messy. Egg custard is so lovely, and honestly it's not too salty. Even though the name is salted egg custard, it's quite a bit sweet, and the bun itself is so fluffy and light. Oh my gosh, look at that. Look at all that salted egg custard just oozing out. Oh my gosh. Now these are pretty special. They're not often sold at dim sum places, which is why we wanted to come here specifically to try this one. And I'm so glad we did, because you can just see this was totally, totally worth it. Oh my gosh. This is amazing. Founded over 200 years ago, Georgetown contains one of the largest collections of pre-war buildings in Southeast Asia. So it's no wonder in 2008 that they were given UNESCO World Heritage status, because the city is just beautiful.
We are here at Restaurant Kimberly. Now this restaurant has been around for over 40 years and it's super famous, and people come flocking here for their duck kuei chap, which is a shredded duck soup. And it's so famous because everything in this bowl is made homemade, from the duck and the noodles right down to the chili sambal. So this bowl looks filled to the brim with so many things. And look at that. Look at the big pieces of rice noodle. There's pig ear and pig intestines. Oh, and look at that coagulated blood as well. So like the pork's blood. Lots of pieces of the duck as well. And a whole entire marinated egg. Wow. I'm gonna have a taste of this broth first. Looks amazing, so dark. Oh, it honestly tastes like I'm eating a whole duck. Such a strong duck flavor in this broth. And I think it's because the juices from the duck, that braised duck, they use it in the broth as well. So it's got that duck fatty flavor to it. It also tastes kind of like a bit of anise flavor and a bit of cinnamon, so it has a bit of that herby spice to it as well. Mmm. So rich though, in flavor. Mmm, and it's so dark because it's a soy sauce based braised soup as well. Wow, it's really cool because the noodles aren't your normal big strands of rice noodle. They're actually nice, big, thick pieces of noodle. When you can see the innards there, that's the pig intestine. Mmm. Super tasty. Nice and chewy, the intestine. And it's packed with pieces of duck as well. I mean, such meaty pieces. Look at that. Such big pieces of duck. Mmm. Super tender. Really juicy still, even though it's been braising in this broth and the soup. Got that nice fatty duck flavor to it. And a little bit of the duck skin on there too, gives it a nice kind of chewiness as well. So traditionally, the kuay chap is made with pork, but they do it special here in Penang and they make it with the duck. Big chunks of the pork blood there. Look at that. Very organy tasting with that blood flavor, like solid blood, almost like a blood sausage kind of flavor to it. And of course, my favorite part of any meal, a nice marinated egg. Mmm. Because it's been marinating, it actually has a bit of like a bitter flavor to the egg. Honestly, it goes so well with the dish and everything in it. Mmm. I gotta try some of this homemade chili sambal. Now you're not supposed to dump it into the broth because it's gonna ruin the taste of the duck braised soup. So you're supposed to dip pieces of the duck and pieces of the soup in there to taste. And it's supposed to cut the richness and the fattiness of the duck broth. Ooh, it smells a little spicy. Not too spicy at all. More sweet than spicy actually. Oh, that is really, really good. Wasn't expecting that. Mm. You can really taste the quality of the ingredients in this soup, and there's so many of them too. Everything is so fresh and handmade. The sambal sauce is amazing. I can see why so many people come here to try this duck kuay chap, because everything just tastes so fresh and amazing, and it shows. Mm. Awesome quality. Ultimate bite. Mm. It's probably my favorite thing we've had in Penang so far. Wow.
It's amazing how multicultural and diverse the city of Penang is. All within about a block of each other, you have a Muslim mosque, a Hindu temple, and a Chinese temple. So it's so wonderful to see all these different religions living in harmony. the famous Hai Ben coffee shop to try their Penang lo mee. Now this dish is quite different than other noodle dishes because it's actually in more of a thick gravy than it is like a soup or other type of sauce. Oh wow, actually look at that. You can see just how sticky the sauce is. Let's see what we've got here. Oh, looks like we have a mix of the thick yellow noodles as well as the vermicelli. We've got an egg, some pork here, bean sprouts. Just mix all that in. Look at that, and it is so thick. You can see just how thick it is. It's quite sticky actually, quite a sticky sauce. Ooh, that's very rich. Mmm. It's got quite an interesting flavor. You can really taste the garlic in there. The gravy is made of a pork and shrimp broth, kind of. So, you can definitely taste that. Kind of a mix between the richness of the meat, but a slight shrimpiness to it as well. But definitely can taste that garlic.
It's got good chunks of pork in there, actually. It's a pretty decent sized piece.
Ooh, that's actually really, really tender. That's lovely. Look at this big egg there. Wow. It's actually huge. Lovely and creamy. Perfect with the noodles. And I really like this actually. It's being more of a gravy than a soup. It's kind of like halfway between sort of like dry, saucy noodles and more of a soup noodle. You can see just how sticky they are because the noodles really, really just cling to that gravy, which gives each bite so much flavor. Oh. They're so good.
Ooh. And look, there's little fried pieces of lard as well.
I love these. So crispy.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
So good, so delicious.
Yeah.
Very, very tasty, thank you. It's an amazing place here.
So we were just brought over the famous Otek Otek, which is a steamed fish cake. So they put it in, they wrap it in the banana leaf and steam it, and it's like a fish cake made with diced onions and spices. So let's see what we got inside this little present. Wow. Oh, we can smell the banana leaf actually. It smells so good. Ooh, look at that. Wow, it's actually quite soft, the Otek Otek here. Oh, look at that. Wow. You can see kind of like the fish paste that it's made with there. I was expecting more of like a firmer fish cake. Oh, wow, it's quite spicy actually. Really can taste a betel leaf flavor as well. The spices really, really pop though. It's made with coconut milk, so it gives it a really nice flavor as well, a coconut flavor. Oh, here's like a firmer part actually. I think this looks like actually a piece of fish. Oh yeah, it is. Oh, So this part is like a fish cake that just kind of falls apart in your hand. But look at this. There's actually pieces of fish there. Wow. Super interesting. That's good. Oh, it's like a white fish. Boneless. Flavor explosion. The spices, the coconut milk. Everything. This is a nice little treat.
The story of the lo mee is grandfather. This is the second generation. Grandson is the third generation.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Wow, wow. So it's three generations, 60 years that this place has been here. Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
So delicious.
Yes.
Toast it.
Okay, thank you.
Thank, thank you so thank much. You. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Thank you so much. Go sick. What an amazing experience. So tasty.
Gotta protect this noggin. While we were eating at the Lo Mi restaurant, a gentleman approached us and said he runs a gelato shop here in Penang. So we're gonna check it out and get some gelato to cool down on this hot day.
Look at all, they're all inside here?
Yeah.
Oh wow.
So that's the traditional way of storing it.
Yeah.
It's for the projecting.
Wow.
So it gives you the right temperature, it prevents the oxygen from going in, the light from going in.
Oh, okay. Wow, look at the color on that mango gelato. Wow.
Icy cold in there.
So we're here at Chow Gelato and we just met with the owner and he recommended us getting the hazelnut gelato, and Steph wanted the calamansi gelato, so we've got a couple different flavors here. I'm gonna try the hazelnut here. I love hazelnut things, so this should be good. Wow, so creamy and so smooth. Little chunks of hazelnut in there as well. Such a strong hazelnut flavor though.
Cool.
So tasty. Mm. Almost tastes kind of like a Ferrero Rocher.
So yummy.
You're so good.
Oh, you're so good.
Oh, wow, that's
amazing.
So, yeah.
And it's so smooth and creamy.
Okay,
so good, oh yeah. Perfect. Perfect for today, it's so hot outside. Amazing.
And I've got the calamansi here. I love sorbets, so I think this is gonna be good. So soft, look at that. Mmm. Such a strong flavor. I was just warned about how strong and tart it was gonna be, and it is, but that is perfect because it's so refreshing on a hot day like today. Mmm. The sorbetto is actually so creamy because it's not made with milk. It's actually not icy or anything like that. It's just so smooth.
Ooh.
Mm. This is so refreshing.
This is the owner here. So if you're ever in Penang and you're hot and you want some gelato to cool you off,
definitely
come to Chow Gelato.
Oh,
thank
yes.
you, thank you so much. It's amazing.
So much.
Thank you.
So delicious.
So tasty. We're off now to try another Penang specialty, wonton mee. Now, the shop that we're going to makes them in a very traditional and super cool way, so this should be really exciting and fun to watch.
behind me here, you can see the worker is making the wonton noodles in the traditional kind of Cantonese Hong Kong method with a bamboo stick. So it's riding on the bamboo stick to kind of press down the noodles, to mix in all the ingredients of the egg and the flour and flatten them. So it's super cool to see them press like this. Very, very unique. They're the only bamboo pressed noodle shop here in Penang and really in Northern Malaysia as well. So really special to see this being prepared. That looks super fun and I really want to ride that bamboo stick. It's so tiring actually. You really need some good leg muscles in there to, it's like all on your like hamstrings and your quads. It's super nice of them to let me ride that bamboo stick. So the gentleman was saying they only do this on Saturday and Sundays, and after he said about two or three, he's already really tired, but they usually do around four or five. His form is a lot better than mine, I think.
It takes a lot of practice. So after working up a massive appetite, pressing the noodles on the bamboo pole over there, we just had to get ourselves a couple of bowls of the wonton noodles, the freshly made wonton noodles. So we got two different bowls. We got the classic wonton soup noodles. So it comes with nice Chinese kale, some big plump wontons, and the freshly made bamboo egg noodles, as well as a Tok Tok Mee special dry wonton mee, which comes with the wontons, as well as some nice char siu barbecue pork as well. And it comes with this chili sambal here, which is a specialty in Penang to have your wonton meat with some chili sambal. Wow, you can see all the noodles in there. You get a pile of noodles in here. Mmm. Those are really light and springy as well. You can really taste that handmade taste and flavor of the noodles. So fresh and not too salty, the broth. Mmm, nice and light as well. It's really nice. And the crunchy with the Chinese kale. Mmm, gotta get into these wontons here. They're pretty big and plump there. You can see the skin, the wonton skin, but the actual insides,
Get a big piece of meat in there. Mmm, pork wonton. Really meaty. Lots of meat in there. Nice and salty, but just goes perfect with the wonton noodles as well. Mmm, so yummy. That wonton soup noodle is good, but I'm really looking forward to trying the Tok Tok's signature dry wonton mee here. And each bowl contains 4 wontons, so you get a nice, decent amount of them here. There's pieces of the lard fat in there. And the way they make the dry noodle is with lard oil and soy sauce. So let's just mix this up here. See the nice dark color of the soy sauce there?
So many noodles.
Yeah, you get a pile of noodles. And with the tasu and the meat too. So really, you get a really full bowl of food. Look at those dry noodles. Wow, that is really tasty. You get that nice sesame oil, and it's a bit oily from the lard oil that they use to mix it with, but have a nice kind of sweetness from the soy sauce that's used. Really different than the soup noodle here, but just as tasty. Try the tasu. The tasu barbecue pork is nice and tender, freshly made today as well. You can see they give you a decent amount of pieces in there. Just covered in that soy sauce as well. Gotta try some of this chili sambal here as well. Just gonna dip my wonton in there. I hope this isn't spicy. Surprisingly, it has a kick, but it almost has kind of like a sweet and salty flavor to it. It kind of builds the heat. That is really nice with the wonton there. Actually, I'm gonna put some into the noodle here. Mix it around as well. Mix in with the soy sauce there. That's a good combo. Nice and spicy, but sweet from the soy sauce. This was such a fun experience coming here to Tok Tok Mee to watch the wonton noodles made in the traditional way with the bamboo pole. And both of these noodles were amazingly tasty. I like the dry noodles better because there was just a little bit more to it with the tasu and the lard. So I definitely recommend coming here and getting both types because they're both so tasty. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Oh, amazing experience here. And they even gave us some pastries to take home with us. Amazing hospitality.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Roy Saya.
Thank you. Unforgettable experience.
Thanks for watching, everyone. We hope you've enjoyed our street food tour of Penang today. If you have, give the video a like. Let us know in the comments down below which food was your favorite. And make sure you subscribe to our channel to come on our next food adventure with us. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.